Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Paul Robinson Theater in the Northwest Activity Center. In 1979, 1980 school year, or maybe even 81, the Detroit Board of Education sent me to Corville Elementary School as the new vocal music teacher. Most people there thought I was a rookie teacher. They had no idea that I came with 12 years teaching experience. But in spite of that, I've had a wonderful time at Corville School. Corville School gave me so much love, so much warmth, such a family, that I have lived with that the rest of my life. And I am blessed to be here today with this Corville Concert Choir reunion concert.
We're here to support this wonderful school because these children are out here making a difference in the community.
The choir is just phenomenal. Whenever I get a chance to hear them, I try to do that. They've performed at our church service at Harvard Memorial Baptist Church, and it's just been a great experience for all of us.
I can't tell you how proud I felt when I saw them for the first time many years ago, that here was Corville Choir. They were going somewhere I couldn't remember so long ago, but it was beautiful. And my heart felt warm because I knew that this was from my neighborhood. This was my school.
Mr. Hines is an example of everything teachers should be. He's my first music teacher, and I love music because of him.
And I'm out here today at Chili's supporting Corville Concert Choir. My daughter-in-law, Carletta Hartnick Brown, was a member there in the choir. And she had been talking to me so much about how she enjoyed her days at Corville and what it did for uplifting her. And I believe that she's the person today that she is because of the training that she got from Mr. Hines.
This is Glenn Sturdy, former member of the Corville Castle Choir. Obviously, I support everything about the Corville Castle Choir. Everything that Mr. Hines stands for, everything Mr. Hines has installed, instilled in us. He's helped me in a very, very, very important way how to be a man in life.
Thank you. Thank you. year was 1958. The city was Detroit, Michigan. The band with the dream was Berry Gordy Jr., founder of Motown Records, Pittsfield, USA. Born was the sound that changed the music industry forever. With hit after hit, the world began to listen and take notice. 1958 was 56 years ago, a long time. Things were different. Black music was not played regularly on all records. Black albums were not sold on all records, especially as pictures of the group album. You believe that? Berry Gordy Jr. came up with a great marketing strategy. He began pressing albums, no pictures of the album, just sketches, paintings, and drawings. The albums were accepted in all record stores. The people loved the music, so the album sold. Billions. My parents, your parents, and even our grandparents were influenced by the music of Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, Martha and the Vandellas, the Marvelettes, Barry Wells, Tammy Terrell, Stevie Wonder, the Temptations, Diana Ross, Michael Jackson, Gladys Knight and Pitt. Tonight we give tribute to Motown Records with our version of a Motown medley. Oh,
Before they make that move, let's give them a hand clap. Let's clap for Stevie Wonder. Where is Stevie Wonder? Come on out here, Stevie Wonder. Yeah, Stevie Wonder. Yeah, four top. Michael Jackson. ending with Diana Walsh. And ladies and gentlemen, the famous, actually they were not famous, but they were the best sounding group on albums from Motown. You never knew that there was a Motown studio singer. Come on, let's take a bow. Motown studio singer. Now watch them move for you.
Coordinator for home health care.
I am an assistant manager of a fast food restaurant.
I'm a business owner.
We can dance.
You know you mean the world to me, and you know you helped me so much during those Corville years, and I thank God for you. I also want to thank the Corville concert choir members who could not make all these rehearsals and all these strenuous meetings. Will you please stand? Because you're part of us. I am so glad you were able to come, and I hope we did you proud, did we? Or let's say, I hope we're doing you proud. I had to have some notes because time brings about. Guess that's it. Those of you, let me introduce some more. There are some people in here who support us every year, financially, prayers and all. But your financial contributions help us so, because our summer program and our after school program is not free. And there are some people who just donate year after year after year. And there are some who tell me over and over, I'm in the prayers, I can't do what you do. But here's the best that I can do to help you. And I really appreciate you. Anybody who has given me whatever or even your prayers, please stand. Come on, those people who give me donations. I want to tell you, you are keeping us alive. We're in the city of Detroit. Our money comes from you. On paper, we also get money from the city. Did you hear what I said? On paper, we get money from the city. And I want you to know that if you normally give and you're a little bit slow this year, it's all right. Go ahead and give it, because guess what? The city has us under contract since January 2014, and we haven't received a penny yet. And our program is in week 3, and we have 5 more weeks to go. And thank you so much in advance for just going back in your pockets and purses and wallets, and looking on the back of that program and seeing that address. Thank you for helping us. Thank you for helping us in the past. Thank you for helping us presently. And thank you for helping us in the future. And keep me in your prayers, because I'm at the place now where my body is talking to me. And my mind is listening, sort of. It's listening. It's listening. But thank you so very much. Thank you for coming out. And the next half, we're going to church. Praise God, praise God. I'm going to speak a second to give them a little breather. I have to read everything. I've been on part-time summer music camp duty due to my recent two back surgeries. And thank you for your thank you cards, for your love, for your prayers and your blessings, and keep on blessing. Keep on praying for me. Those of you who dealt with back and spine, oh, no people, it's something that doesn't heal immediately. So just keep me in your prayers. In the meantime, my 2014 summer music camp has a missed to be. Aria Crosby, please come up here, please. She was one of the principal singers during the Easter time in Perilous Times. So if any of you all want to see that, that's who you heard. She's a graduate of Kentucky State University, where I went. And she's going to introduce the summer coaches and the summer camp interns. These are people who are helping me out.
Demetrius Farley. Destiny Woods. Christopher Harris. Asia Thomas. Siobhan Galt. Ivante Corbin. Kiana Linton. Betty Alexandria Pride. And you couldn't be here with us today, but our other coach is Rod Hines as well. And Jesse Wilson.
For some who don't know our purpose, may not understand our praise, we as a family in Jesus' name would like to tell you the reason why we sing. Family?
Someone asked a question. Why do we sing? When we lift our hands to Jesus, what do we really mean?
I sing because I'm happy.
I sing because I'm happy.
I sing because
I'm free.
His eye is on
the sparrow.
That's the reason why I sing.
That's the reason why I sing.
I just step up and want to say glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason why
I sing.
I just want to say glory.
Glory,
say it again.
Someone asked the question.
Oh, glory. Why do we sing?
Why do we sing?
When we lift our hands.
When we lift our hands to Jesus.
Oh, what do we really mean?
What do we really mean?
Someone may be wondering.
Oh, glory.
When we sing our song. And nothing's even wrong.
And nothing's even wrong.
I tell you why I sing because
I'm happy.
I sing because
I'm free.
Oh, I don't know why it doesn't, but his eye is
his
on.
His eye is on the sparrow.
That's the reason why I sing.
That's the reason why I sing.
Come on, somebody help me say it. Glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason, Jesus.
You're the reason why I sing.
I just step back and want to say glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
I know somebody can help me say it. Glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
I give the praises to you, Lord.
I give the praises to you.
Oh, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason.
You're the reason why I sing.
But when the song is over.
When the song is over.
We've all said amen.
We've all said amen.
Your heart just keep on
and
singing.
Your heart singing,
and the song will never
end. And the song will never end.
And if somebody asks you,
and if somebody asks you,
was it just a show?
Was it just a show?
Lift your hands and be a witness.
Lift your hands and be a witness.
And tell the whole world no.
And tell the whole world no.
And when we cross that river.
And when we cross that river.
Study war no more.
We will sing. We will sing our songs to
Jesus. The one who will adore.
The one who we adore.
Let's take it home, family. I sing because.
I sing because I'm happy.
I sing because.
I sing because I'm free.
I don't know why it does it, but his eye is on.
His eye is on the sparrow.
That's the reason why I sing.
That's the reason why I sing.
Come on, y'all help me say it. Glory.
Glory.
Better than that. Glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason.
You're the reason why I sing.
I just want to say glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
I give the praises to you, Lord.
I give the praises to you.
Oh, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason, Jesus.
You're the reason why I sing.
You're the reason why I sing.
You're the reason why.
You're the song in my storm, Jesus.
You're the reason why I sing.
You're the reason why.
You're the reason why I sing.
Oh, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. I love you, Jesus. I love your name, Jesus. And for the rest of my life, Jesus, you'll be the reason why I sing.
Oh, come on, put your hands together.
Come on, put your hands together. If you know he's the reason why you sing, I don't think you believe it. Hallelujah. He's the reason why I sing. A month ago I had to bury my father, but he gave me a song to sing. Come on, God, I ask you to know. He may not be in the church, but you say whether the two are together, in his name he'll be in the midst.
Hallelujah. I feel good tonight. I came all the way from Mississippi and I had to come to look at you. Hallelujah. Well, we come to give God the glory. For 33 years of the Corville Concert Choir. That's, I'm sorry, y'all don't want to praise him. They don't want to praise him. Because the presence of the Lord is here.
The presence of the Lord is here. Oh,
the presence of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Anybody feel it? The Spirit of the Lord is here. I feel in the atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Oh, the Spirit of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. Power. The power. The power of the Lord is here. Oh, the power of the Lord is here.
Come on, put your hands together. If you feel the presence, we got some walkers named in the presence. Now watch. How about CCC?
Oh, the presence.
I'm gonna get high. I just wanted to take a few minutes. Definitely, let's give him a hand one more time, y'all. Hey, real quick, I just wanted to take a quick minute to say a few words. Just a few words, Mr. Hines. He doesn't even know that we were going to do this. But, I mean, Mr. Hines, for those of you that know, I mean, he's been working with, you know, the Corville Concert Choir over 30 years. And, Mr. Hines, yeah, let's give it up for that. 30 years he's been working with the Corville Concert Choir. And, I mean, for those of you that know, I mean, Mr. Hines puts his heart, his soul, I mean, his everything into the children, into the choir. And like you mentioned earlier, so much is so that he's had to have two back surgeries. He's had operations on his heart. I mean, and I know that, you know, that's a direct, you know, impact on his body of what he gives up, you know, for us. And, you know, we're very appreciative, you know, Mr. Hines, and working with inner city youth. I mean, he's been able to allow inner city kids that probably would not have ever been able to see some of the places they've gone. This choir has traveled all over the world. And that's because of Mr. Hines' dedication. And we just want to give you a token of our appreciation. I mean, you've changed all of our lives, and we thank you, and we love you.
Thank you so much. I just want you to know that your gift to me is just your love for me. Brother Thompson, I love you.
All right, thank everybody for coming out. We hope you enjoyed this event and continue to support the Corville Concert Choir.